This video is not intended for children under 13 years old.
Hello everyone, Max here.
And I'm Sebastian. You might know us from the Gravity Max livestream, or you may be new to our channel.
Today, we are talking about NASA's HAVOC program to send manned missions to Venus. HAVOC stands for High Altitude Venus Operational Concept. The purpose of this mission is to explore Venus and to eventually establish a permanent human presence on Venus. This goal requires 5 phases according to NASA. They start with unmanned robotic missions and end with permanent habitation.
Starting at the beginning with Phase 1, to kick off the exploration of Venus, a robotic mission will commence. There have been probes sent to Venus before, however, this one will be very different. Previous Venus probes have flown to the planet and landed on its surface. Because of the harsh conditions on the surface of Venus, these probes were quickly destroyed. Phase 1 of HAVOC will avoid this destruction by avoiding the surface. The probe's parachutes will deploy at 82.7 kilometers in Venus's upper atmosphere so that it comes to a stop 66.2 kilometers above the surface of Venus. At that point, the probe will unfold and inflate an envelope of helium so that its buoyancy keeps it aloft in the air. The envelope will be 8 meters tall and 31 meters long. It will carry a vast array of scientific instruments including drop probes, drop balloons, and a lander to study Venus's atmosphere. Hopefully, this mission will answer some of our outstanding questions about Venus. This mission will also serve as a test run and proof of concept for the later human missions.
Moving on, we have Phase 2 of the HAVOC missions. This phase involves sending a crew to Venus, having them enter Venus orbit, then having them go home. Yes, it may seem a little anticlimactic and counterproductive to go all the way to Venus and not even enter its atmosphere, however, it is an important step. Looking back at the Apollo missions, we see that Apollo 8 orbited the moon without landing, and Apollo 10 got its lander to 8.4 kilometers above the lunar surface before flying upwards again to re-enter lunar orbit and go home. These two missions aided in the success of Apollo 11's landing on the moon. In a similar fashion, HAVOC Phase 2 will aid in the entrance of Phase 3 into Venus's atmosphere. HAVOC Phase 2 will encompass 440 days in space. It will take 110 days to get from Earth to Venus, 30 days to remain in Venus's orbit, and 300 days to return. That is a long time to remain in the zero-gravity environment of space, especially in a tiny 4.3 meter tall, 5.9 meter wide cylinder. However, it has been done before. Valery Polyakov, a former Russian cosmonaut, holds the record for the longest continuous stay in space at 437 days. Although his mood fluctuated a little at first, it quickly stabilized. His cognitive functions experienced no decline. When he returned to Earth, he had no permanent physical impairments. This evidence shows that a mission such as this one will not be permanently harmful to its astronauts.
With a successful Phase 2 dress rehearsal, NASA will move on to Phase 3. Phase 3 is similar to Phase 2 in some ways. The mission will also encompass 440 days, 110 to get to Venus, 30 within Venus's atmosphere, and 300 days to get back. The mission will require 2 interplanetary vessels. One will be sent to Venus without a crew to be used in Venus's atmosphere, then the other will be sent to Venus with a crew. The two vessels will rendezvous in Venus's orbit, then the originally uncrewed one will descend into Venus's atmosphere after the crew have transferred to it. Shedding its interplanetary shell and allowing its helium envelope to inflate, the Venus habitat can be inhabited by the crew for the course of 1 month. When the month is over, an ascent vehicle will drop away from the gaseous envelope, then launch into low Venus orbit to return to the original interplanetary vessel for the trip back to Earth. If the airship on Venus can be maintained while people are away, then return trips can be made that utilize the same habitat. The most interesting part of this mission, of course, will be the 30 days on Venus. While it isn't the classic first step or planting of a flag on the planet's surface, it will be the first human habitation on Venus. A massive scale up from the robotic mission of Phase 1, the Phase 3 envelope of helium will be 34 meters tall and 129 meters long. There will be 70 times the helium lifting gas contained in this envelope, because there will be 70 times the mass contained in the payload. The habitat for the crew on Venus will be a cramped 2.9 by 3 by 4 meters, a step down from the slightly roomier transit habitat. While that will be difficult for the crew, that is the life of an astronaut, and they will be trained for it. More research will be conducted during this phase, but its main accomplishment will be the development and demonstration of technologies allowing humans to live on other planets.
Next, we move to Phase 4. Phase 4 has not been fleshed out as much as the previous 3 phases, however, thought has been put into it. Phase 4 is targeted to involve a year-long stay on Venus. That is 12 times as long as the previous phase's stay on Venus, and it is longer than its 2 interplanetary travel phases. As a result, Havoc Phase 4 will require a larger habitat for crew to live in. As a result of that, it will require a larger buoyant envelope. This increasing size of habitats on Venus will allow for more extensive human habitation on the planet. With longer and more frequent stays, more research can be conducted. Phase 4 of Havoc will give us much more information about Venus, namely its formation, the formation of other planets in the solar system, and human habitation on other worlds. Increasing the length of missions will also allow the Havoc mission to transition into Phase 5.
Finally, we reach Phase 5 of Havoc, the end of the project. In Phase 5, habitats on Venus will be massively scaled up. No longer will the astronauts have to put up with cramped habitation. By the end of Phase 5, infrastructure on Venus will be enough to support full towns and eventually cities on the planet. At that point, the project will end as it has gone from missions to settlement on Venus.
What will cities on Venus look like in the far future after this early habitation project?
Well, it can't be known for sure, but we worked with Futurology to theorize.
To check out Futurology's video, the second part to our video, click on the link in the description and make sure to subscribe to him, as his videos are well animated and educational. Thanks for watching.